Okay, notes for a rhombus. By definition, a rhombus is a parallelogram with four right angles. So we're going to go ahead and show that with our arrows. Opposite sides are parallel. But also by definition, and I said four right angles, I'm sorry, with four congruent sides. So we're going to do tick marks, one tick mark for each side because all the sides are congruent. Now I went ahead and drew the diagonals here because by definition, it's a parallelogram. So by definition, if it's a parallelogram, the diagonals bisect each other. So I'm going to do two tick marks and three tick marks. And by definition, if it's a parallelogram, opposite angles, so my obtuse angles are congruent to each other, and my acute angles are congruent to each other. Now, the thing that's a little different for a parallelogram, some additional properties, is if we look at this, we have four congruent sides, it's a parallelogram, I can move it, I can rotate it, I'm going to keep opposite sides parallel. But if I show my diagonals here, I'm showing that they're bisecting because I can see, I can change the side, 9.6, 4.6, 4.96. I'm showing that each part is congruent. But the other thing that happens, oops, is that the diagonals also bisect the opposite angles. If you look here, the red angle, my obtuse angle is 58.76 and 58.76. It happens across from that too. I can change the size. Same thing. My acute 32.92. We can see that the angles are being bisected. But also, the diagonals are perpendicular. Okay? And an additional relationship is that if I look at one diagonal, it is also a line of symmetry. I can reflect, and that piece will map into the other part. So, what we need to add to our notes, to our page here, is that we need to. I'm going to do tick marks, and this is just another way of showing congruency on an angle. I'm going to do one tick mark in each of my obtuse angles, and I'm going to do two in my acute to show that they're being bisected. Also, I need to add the box to show that the diagonals are perpendicular. So hopefully you see, just like with all our other special quadrilaterals, the diagonals do form things in the interior. Diagonals form four congruent. They're congruent because if you notice, here's my one, two, three, four. If I look at one, triangle one has two tick marks, three tick marks, one tick mark. One is the hypotenuse. So I look at triangle three, same thing. Leg is two, leg is three, hypotenuse is one. So it's not just four triangles, they're four congruent right, because where their diagonals are perpendicular, making that right angle, scalene triangles. Okay, four congruent right scalene triangles. Now this helps with my angles because if I know that, for example, this angle is 30, well, it's going to be 30 in every triangle, right? Triangle. If this is 30, this has to be 60 in every of the right triangles, okay? And then in a situation like this, we could use, that doesn't look like a 60, we can use our relationships with our 30, 60, 90 triangles, if that was the case. Now, as for properties, since it's a parallelogram, it holds all the properties of a parallelogram. So instead of listing all five of them, just know that it has all the properties of a parallelogram. Now, something special for a rhombus is that all sides are congruent. Parallelogram, that doesn't happen. Okay? We have all the diagonals are perpendicular, and we have diagonals bisect opposite angles. So that is our notes for our rhombus. Now we're going to get into some examples. Thanks.